Hey guys, Cube Hamster here, and welcome to the How to Defuse Missiles tutorial for Missile Wars, a game by me and Seth Bling. In this video, I will show you how you can manually manipulate all the missiles, so stop them, defuse them, trigger them halfway while flying them, and how you can blow them up with flame arrows. In the annotations, you will see links to all the different missiles, so you can just skip to the missile you want to know something about, and at all times you'll be able to click back to the main menu where you can select the missiles. And if you're on a mobile device, you're out of luck and you have to just skim through the entire video. But let's get going. Starting off with the Tomahawk missile, one of the sort of sturdy missiles that is very easy to manipulate. You will notice that there's one TNT block that gets dangerously close to the redstone block while moving. That is the trigger mechanism. So what you can do is, if there's a barrier and you see you're about to hit it, you can get rid of this block, and it will allow the missile to go come to a stop without getting triggered and exploding. So that's a thing you can do. Another way you can manipulate missiles, or the Tomahawk, is if you destroy the right TNT, you can actually detonate it manually before it stops moving. Or at least it stops moving and then it detonates. And the way you can do that is by removing this TNT block. And that will trigger the primer and the whole thing will explode. And this can be very useful because you can use it to blow up a lot of the enemy's incoming missiles. If you notice you're like riding a missile, it's detonated and collateral damage will do the rest. Combining these two allows you to bring the missile to a halt without exploding, which also can be very useful because that might give you like an advantage, a platform closer to the enemy's base from which you can spawn missiles. And the way you want to do that is you want to remove the trigger mechanism and then get rid of the primer. And if you then go ahead and remove all the TNT, and then the only way for you to get killed is either by the explosion of another missile or getting hit by a flame arrow is always a danger. Some more advanced tactics with the Tomahawk. What you can do is you can turn it into a bomber. What you want to do is you want to remove this TNT block, oh. And then you want to remove the TNT blocks there, and that will like drop TNT down while still flying. So I removed the wrong block, but like you get the idea. Remove the TNT block, and it brings it to a stop. So let's stop that one as well. And another really interesting thing that you can only do with the Tomahawk is, normally, in order to spawn them and jump on them, you place it four blocks on the edge. What you can actually do is you can also place it five blocks on the edge. And that allows you to get rid of all the TNT by hand. So let's get rid of all that TNT, except for this one. So all the TNT except for one. And what you can then do is you can start it up again by breaking this glass block, and that turns it into a flying machine with only one TNT, no primer, no nothing. It also functions as a shield buster like this. But this is very, very cool because normally the biggest danger when riding a missile is getting hit in the face with a fireball. But there's only one TNT that they can blow up, and even if they somehow hit it with a flame bow, you'll stop, but you won't explode. So you can then stop it somewhere, and you have a very nice platform of which you can summon lots and lots of missiles. Now, the final thing, as for blowing up, it's a good idea to aim for the one that stops it. That's probably the easiest way to detonate it. There's other missiles you can destroy to blow it up. Generally, stopping it somewhere is nice. Let's see, another thing you can try and blow up is go for the trigger mechanism. Oh, let's try it again. So it turns into a dot, and then you defuse the missile manually. These are some of the easiest ways to defuse a Tomahawk and manipulate a Tomahawk. So yeah, so much for the tomahawk. Okay, moving on to the juggernaut. Same as before, the juggernaut also has a primed, or like a primer that detonates the missile on impact. And if you get rid of it, and you end up flying against a barrier, for instance, nothing will happen. So if you're riding it and you notice you're about to hit something that you, yeah, where you don't want it to explode on impact, and just get rid of that, and that should solve your problem. Stopping it midair is also a possibility. While riding it, the easiest way to go about doing that is by destroying the slime block at the front, so that stops it without it detonating, and then you can get rid of all the TNT without any issue. And this one's a bit more tricky, but what you can do is you can also stop it by getting rid of the TNT that's in the back. Oh, that's actually funny. I'm not sure what happened there. I think I destroyed. Oh, I destroyed the piston. Let's do it again. So my recording software has been a bit iffy lately, which is why this video took a bit longer. But so can we get it? Can we get it? There we go. So that stops it as well. Now detonating it while it is going is actually fairly difficult. There isn't really any. No, there isn't really any manually way of setting it on fire while it's going, besides maybe having a fireball and then blowing it up like that. But yeah, that is a way to go about stopping and getting rid of the trigger mechanism on the juggernaut. Now, as for trying to blow it up with arrows, you'll notice that hitting it on the front doesn't always give the right effect. Most of the time it falls through. What you want to try and do is you want to try and aim for the front TNT on the left. That's the best way to ignite it with TNT. Even that doesn't always work though. I mean, it is the juggernaut. It's called the juggernaut for a reason. But at least you've got rid. If you hit the TNT on the front, you will have gotten rid of the primer, so this doesn't explode. So let's actually do that again. Spawn another one. There isn't really a fail-proof way of blowing it up with arrows. Most of the TNT just falls down. So let's try that again. There we go. So that was on the left side. That one's sort of semi-reliable. Another way you can go about defusing this one is, which is a bit more tricky and mostly involves you being already somewhere halfway across the map. But like I said, if you manage to get rid of one of the TNTs that is pushing in the back, that immediately stops it. It doesn't ignite it, it set it on fire, but it stops it. And sometimes you don't actually want it to explode. If you're nearby on a missile, then you just want to ignite or just get it to come to a halt, pretty much. But yeah, so much for defusing and stopping the juggernaut. Now then, the shield buster. As many of you guys have noticed, the reason this thing is called the shield buster is because it busts through the barriers that you can get with snowballs. If you're riding it, the trigger mechanism is this TNT block. If you hit that, then there's no problem. If you want to stop this machine, it can be a bit tricky. What you want to try and do is try and get rid of the slime block at the front. That stops it without it blowing up. Make sure you will have removed the trigger mechanism though before you do it. Normally there's no glass blocks there, so that shouldn't be an issue. So let me show you that again. So, first, get rid of the trigger, and then get rid of the slime block at the front. And you have your stationary platform. Let me think now, is there a way to detonate this halfway while it's going? An easy way. I think the easiest, the way to ignite this while it is going. Oh, I fell through. the way to get ignite this while it is going is to get rid of one of the TNTs in the back, or one of these blocks, for that matter. Gives the same result. That ignites it somewhere halfway. Now for blowing it up with arrows. This missile is relatively easy to detonate with arrows. You can choose to hit the TNT at the front. It's always very reliable. Alternatively, you can hit one of the TNTs in the back. Gives the same result. And another thing that some people don't realize, you can actually still stop this with a barrier. All you have to do though is you have to throw it a bit to the side. And seeing as the barrier replaces blocks, it messes things up. This works for most of the missiles, by the way. So even if you can't stop it with a barrier from the front, you can still kind of cut the missile in half and then mess things up where it doesn't continue anymore. That's how you manipulate the shield buster. Then we have the Guardian, kind of a special missile designed to reflect incoming arrows. The main trigger TNT is completely covered, or from the front, completely covered. But obviously you can still get rid of it, and that will cause it to not explode on bumping into something else. So that's a way to get rid of the trigger mechanism while you're riding it, and also a way to stop trigger mechanisms. Like if you get into position where you can shoot that block with an arrow, that's a way to get rid of the trigger mechanism. Now if you want to stop it manually while riding it, all you have to do is get rid of this slime lock at the front. That will make sure that the TNT doesn't explode, and then you can get rid of stuff. Be careful though, because sometimes when you remove TNT it might update a little bit. Defusing the Guardian by hand is fairly easy. There are some interesting tactics involved. You can spawn it without it having an effective trigger mechanism by placing it on the fifth block. This thing will get going, but this will no longer detonate on impact right now. So if you're unsure of getting rid of the TNT, then this is a way to spawn a missile without a functioning trigger mechanism. It does consume a bit of the glass on the wall though. And another very, very interesting mechanic is, while you're riding it, if you get rid of the front left slime block, you end up with a stationary platform where the rest of the missile continues going. Which is kind of interesting. And so that's a very easy way to get a platform without a lot of TNT. And if you are heading towards a missile and you want to explode the missile, you can get rid of this block and then just have the rest of the thing continue flying. Now this obviously doesn't explode on impact, but it is a very interesting mechanic. So it's if you see a missile incoming and you want to defuse it and have like a new platform with a bit further ahead, then this is the way to go about doing that with the Guardian. It is also possible to ignite the TNT while it's going. In order to do that, you have to get on front of the Guardian and brake the front right block that basically ignites it and can be very useful to blow up people that are below you or you know, missiles that surround you. Stopping a guardian with bow and arrow is impossible. That's how it's designed. You can, however, if you're a pretty good shot, get rid of the trigger mechanism by hitting it in the little corner where there's the glass, and that will just make it so that it doesn't explode on impact, which sometimes is enough. But there isn't really any way of hitting a TNT and causing it to explode. All this TNT just drops down whenever you hit it. Oh. But yeah, the Guardian, quite an interesting missile. And finally, there is the Lightning, the missile that is twice as fast as all the other missiles. It's also the most complex, and that literally means that the trigger mechanism is at the front. So get rid of that, it doesn't explode on impact. There we go. Perfect. There's that, and so if you get rid of the front TNT, that stops it from exploding, which can be tricky on leggy surface, by the way. But alternatively, it really doesn't matter what you destroy when it comes to the slime box in this machine at the surface, because it will mess up. Like, really, there isn't really any ways you can go wrong just because of the way this thing works. Like, every slime block is functional in that aspect. Now, I can imagine igniting it. You would want to go and remove this one at the front, so that allows it to allows you to explode it somewhere midair. That also means that if you're defusing it close to your base, you probably don't want to remove that slime block. As for hitting it with arrows, this missile is fairly easy to disable with arrows. All you have to do is hit a TNT on the side. That can be the one in the back, it can be one in the middle, but yeah, anything but the front TNT on this one should cause it to stop. So let's try and aim for the middle one. That makes it stop as well. So this is actually probably, with arrows, the easiest missile to defuse, funny enough. This is also, like, riding this one though can be extremely tricky. I've seen people actually manage to jump on it quick enough, like placing it and then jumping. Oh, I can't really do it right now while recording, without any issue. But it is possible. But the easiest way is to jump on it from like another missile. Cool thing though is that, let's see if we can get this. No. The missile actually partially functions as a shield buster. Let's see if I can get that going. No. The front piston is pushing like four blocks. So if you don't put your barrier down like relatively good, like a poor barrier will not stop this. As you can see, there's a good chance, so make sure that you throw your barrier properly when you try and disable this. But yeah, disabling it by hand at the last moment can be tricky. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this tactical guide for Missile Wars. And I hope to see a lot of you guys come up with your own tactics as well. If you have any questions or any awesome suggestions that I've missed, because even though I made these missiles, there might have been things I've overlooked, post them in the comments. I look forward to seeing them. And yeah, please leave a like on the video, subscribe, and I will see you all later. Bye-bye.